The Trakkutter is a tool that allows you to cut, edit and sample your music, videos and photos. To bring media into the Trakkutter, simply double click on the file in the media browser or drag the file onto an available tab. A nice feature of the Trakkutter is that you can quickly navigate between multiple files within the Trakkutter using the tab function. Firstly, let's show you some audio in the Trakkutter. If you wish to hear the audio in the Trakkutter, click the play button. To stop the audio, hit stop. If you wish to jump to the beginning of the file, hit the jump to start button. If you'd like to play the MIDI in reverse, click on the play in reverse button. Another new feature we've added is the ability to scrub through your media by clicking on the top section of the play bar and scrubbing through either direction of your file. This is a very helpful tool when making exact cuts. You can also grab the play bar and move it to any location in the file. You can also use the play position pot to move easily through your file, or just left click with your mouse in the position you want. So now we'll move on and show you how to edit and sample your file. To sample a section of your file, holding the shift key on your keyboard while holding down the left mouse button, and a grey selection box will appear. This selection box shows the exact area that will be sampled from your file. This selection box can be adjusted in length. To do this, position your mouse at the start or end of the box, and the adjust length indicators will appear. While holding down the left mouse button, drag in the direction to achieve the desired length. Click play to hear the sample section. Click on the loop play button to hear it looped. If you're happy with your loop selection, simply right-click on the grey box, select copy, and right-click in the area you wish to paste in the mixing screen, and select paste. As you can see, the looped area is now in the mixing screen, and is ready to be used in the mix. I'll just quickly show you how I use this loop in a mix. I've simply built up a mix using hip-hop loops from my track packs with my sampled loop. Track pack loops are available from trakax.com. I'll click play to listen to my mix. You'll now hear some of the hip-hop loops coming in. I'll click stop to stop the mix. So now I'll move back to the Trakkutter. If you'd like to move the selection box to other areas within the Trakkutter, click and hold the left mouse button and move to any location you desire. When adjusting the length of the selection box, you'll notice the box will snap to the grid lines within the Trakkutter, which is trying to create a seamless loop. You can turn this feature off by right-clicking outside the box and unchecking the Snap to Grid option. You're also able to adjust the length of the selection box by moving or scrubbing your play cursor to the position you wish the box to start. Right-click and select Snap Start to Play Cursor. You can also position the cursor where you want it to end, right-click and select Snap End to Play Cursor. You are also able to zoom in and out of the Trakkutter window, which helps you to get an exact cut. You can use the scroll wheel on your mouse, or the zoom in and out icons in the bottom right hand corner of the Trakkutter. You can also adjust the BPM of the audio file by adjusting the tempo pot or inputting a new BPM into the tempo field. When the tempo is changed, the preserve pitch icon is defaulted to on. If you'd like to change this, click on the preserve pitch icon. This will alter the pitch to either higher or lower depending on the BPM you've entered. To restore the BPM to its original tempo, click on the Restore Original Tempo icon. If you wish to override the detected BPM or improve the stretching quality, click on the BPM Parameters icon. This is discussed further in the BPM Global Tempo tutorials. You can also alter the pan by adjusting the pan pot left or right. You can mute the audio, increase or decrease the volume using the volume slider. You can also boost the volume by right-clicking on the volume slider. If you wish to export the whole file or a selection of it, which has been created, to a different file format, such as MP3, M4A or WAV, click on the export button. This is a really nice feature if you wish to convert a file, create loops for a mix, edit or convert a selection of a podcast or a large audio file. To learn more, see the exporting files video.